الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وبعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. The Imam recited for us today the story of Yunus عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah جل وعلا speaks about him in القرآن in سورة أنبياء. Where he says, جل وعلا فنادى في الظلمات أن لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. Then he says سبحانه وتعالى فاستجبنا له ونجيناه من الغم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين. Allah سبحانه وتعالى speaks about the story of Yunus عليه السلام and the tawbah of Yunus, the repentance of Yunus عليه السلام. In a hadith reported by Ibn Abi Hatim on the authority of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, and Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu. Whilst the scholars of Islam differ regarding the absolute authenticity of this hadith, some of the scholars of tafsir mentioned that since the hadith on this topic are many in number, they kind of support one another to make it into a stage that is referred to as Hasan bi ghayrihi wallahu a'lam. Anyhow, the scholars of Islam, they mention that when Yunus alayhi salam was swallowed up by the whale, after he fled his city without the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he was thrown into the sea, he was swallowed by the whale by the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whilst he was in this whale, he sought repentance, he sought forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by reciting this dua, as Allah jalla wa ala says, فَنَادَى فِي الظُّلُمَاتِ. When he was in the darkness of this whale, and he had no form of rescue or success, or salvation. He says that Yunus alayhi salam said, Allah ilaha illa ant. There is none worthy of worship except for you, Allah. Subhanak. Glory be to you. Inni kuntu min al-zalimin. Indeed, he says, I was one of those people who erred. I made a mistake. I transgressed my rights. I sinned, he says. And he kept on repeating this dua over and over and over again. And then in this hadith of Anas ibn Malik and hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala an, قالت الملائكة, the ملائكة, they heard this sound of Yunus. They heard the voice of Yunus. So they went to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they said to him, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, هذا صوت ضعيف معروف من بلاد بعيدة غريبة. So we recognize this voice of somebody. We recognize it, but it's from a place that we normally don't hear it from. From a place that is far, from a place that is strange, but we recognize his voice. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, أَمَا تَعْرِفُونَ ذَلِكَ. Don't you know who this person is? قَالُوا the malaika say, يَا رَبِّ وَمَنْ هُوَ. Oh Lord, who is it? قَالَ عَزَّ وَجَلَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to them, this is Yunus. The malaika, they say, قالوا, they say, your slave Yunus, the one who used to worship you, الذي لم يزل يرفع له عمل, the one to whom the actions kept on being raised up to the heavens, متقبل ودع ومستجاب, the one whose actions were always accepted and his du'as were always answered, that Yunus. Allah جل وعلا says yes. They then said to him سبحانه وتعالى, قالوا يا ربي, oh our Lord, are you not going to forgive the person that used to remember you in open, that used to remember you in ease, now that he's remembering you in difficulty? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then decreed for the whale to open its mouth and Yunus to be saved and be given success and salvation and freedom and his tawbah be accepted. From this hadith, the scholars of Islam, they mention and the story of Yunus, there are many benefits that we can take. And from amongst them is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted the tawbah of Yunus because the malaika, they knew who he was, and Allah jalla wa ala knew who he was before them. As in, Yunus was somebody that used to always worship Allah. His action used to always be raised up to the heavens. He used to always make dua to Allah in ease, in difficulty, when he was free, when he was oppressed, when he was a free man on the streets, when he was in the stomach of the whale. Allah Jalla wa Ala
knew Yunus to be a pious and righteous slave. The Malaika knew him to be a pious and righteous slave. The Malaika knew him to be a pious and righteous slave. And this is what the scholars of Islam, they say, how do you think Allah Jalla wa Ala really knows you by? We may make ourselves known to other people by many different characteristics, by many different actions, by perhaps our professions, or our cultures, or our traditions, or our wealth. Or we may be excellent in a particular field, maybe a person who is very active in sports or whatever, wallahu a'lam. We've made ourselves known to people by the dunya. But how have we made ourselves known to Allah Jalla wa Ala? Yunus made himself known to Allah and the Malaika to the extent that the Malaika went to Allah and said to Allah, oh Allah, you're not going to forgive Yunus? This Yunus, whose actions were often raised, his du'as were always accepted. This Yunus, he's in the whale. You're not going to forgive him? This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said. In the hadith reported by Abu Hurairah radiallahu ta'ala, he said, من أنفق زوجين في سبيل الله نودي من أبواب الجنة يا عبد الله هذا خير. Whoever gives for his spouse for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, نودي من أبواب الجنة, who be called by the gates of Jannah, O slave of Allah, this is very good. فمن كان من أهل الصلاة دعي من باب الصلاة. And whoever made themselves known, whoever became a person of salah in this world, meaning he fulfilled the obligatory actions of the salah, he performed his 5 daily prayers, but then he went beyond and he performed the voluntary prayers, the optional prayers. He kept on making himself known as the one who prays salah. Salah was something that made him find rest. So he performed salah and he exceeded performing salah, performing the qiyam al-layl and the tahajjud and every possible voluntary prayer. He made himself known to Allah as the person who performs salah. Nudiya min abwab as-salah. He'll be called from the gate of salah. Gate of salah is in, on the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have gates for Jannah. And every gate of Jannah will be based upon an action. And this action, salah is the one that will call him. He says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجِهَادِ دُعِيَ مِنْ بَعْدِ الْجِهَادِ. And whoever made himself known, whoever was a person of jihad, he fulfilled jihad, he participated in jihad, his voluntary forms, his obligatory forms, perhaps he gave money towards jihad, or he called Allah Jalla wa Ala asking Allah for victory for the mujahideen. دُعِيَ مِنْ بَعْدِ الْجِهَادِ, he'll be called by the gates of jihad. وَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الصِّيَامِ دُعِيَ مِنْ بَعْدِ الرَّيَّانِ. And whoever was from the أَهْلِ الصِّيَامِ, the people of fast, the people who fulfilled the obligatory forms of fasting, as in the month of Ramadan, and then they went beyond and fasted the voluntary days, the optional days, the Mondays and the Thursdays, the fast of Dawood, the fast of the white days. دُعِيَ مِنْ بَابِ الرَّيَّانِ, who be called by the gate called الرَّيَّانِ. وَمَنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الصَّدَقَةِ دُعِيَ مِنْ بَابِ الصَّدَقَةِ. And whoever's from أَهْلِ الصَّدَقَةِ, those who give charity, not just the obligatory form of zakat, but the voluntary forms of charity in every single respect. دُعِيَ مِنْ بَابِ الصَّدَقَةِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling us in this hadith, just like how Allah Jalla wa Ala spoke to us and gave us a message regarding Yunus, is that who and what are you going to make yourself known by? To Allah Jalla wa Ala. And one of the greatest ways we can find out who we truly are, because Allah Jalla wa Ala has decreed, and this is one of the wisdom as to why He's decreed many different types of ibadat. عبادة is اسم جامع لكل ما يحب الله ويرضى من أقوال والأفعال الظاهرة والباطنة. Is that everything that Allah Jalla wa Ala loves, from the signs or the action that are apparent and hidden, this is ibadah. And in the month of Ramadan, Allah Jalla wa Ala combines many different acts of worship so you can find your act of worship. You fast in the month of Ramadan. You perform the night prayers in the month of Ramadan. You give more charity in the month of Ramadan. You recite the book of Allah in the month of Ramadan. Find your act of worship. Fulfill its obligatory requirements. And then go beyond. And then go beyond. And master all of its voluntary formats. So that you can make yourself known to Allah Jalla wa Ala as a person of that ibadah. As a person of that ibadah. And sometimes this idea doesn't come across our minds. We make ourselves known amongst the people, like I mentioned, through many different professions or sports or actions or characteristics or traditions. But what are we going to make ourselves known to Allah Jalla wa Ala by?
Yunus made himself known to Allah Jalla wa Ala as a man who made dua to Allah and raised his actions. His actions were raised to Allah often. Which action are we going to make ourselves known to Allah Jalla wa Ala by? At the end of this hadith, where the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam spoke about the many actions and the gates of Jannah, Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, فقال أبو بكر said, بأبي وأنت وأمي يا رسول الله, for my, on behalf of my mother or my father, or my mother or father, be sacrificed for you, O Prophet of Allah. Will there be a person that will be called by every single gate? Will there be a person that is known to Allah by all of the acts of worship? He is a man of sadaqah, he is a man of fast, he is a man of jihad, he is a man of salah, he is a man of giving and looking after his spouse. Will there be a person that be called by every single gate? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, yes, and I hope that you are from them. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an was from them. May Allah jalla wa ala make us from them as well. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala beautify ibadah for us and enable us to find rest in it. Make us of those who are known to Allah Jalla wa Ala sincerely for Him as the people who pray Salah, who give charity, who partake in Jihad, and who fast in the month of Ramadan and beyond. Jazakumullahu khairan wa qulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullaha li wa lakum wa lisa'il muslimin fastaghfiruh.